It was an accidental inland paradise. The California Development Company sought to make fertile land for agriculture. By cutting canals in the desert sands to divert the Colorado River, the company miscalculated and an ocean 376 square miles was created in the desert. People, boats, and sports fishermen would come from all around to be entranced by this man-made novelty. Over 400 species of birds called the Salton Sea home, or at least a rest stop on their migration path, which made Salton Sea a mecca for birdwatchers. The low elevation and increased buoyancy made the perfect conditions for daredevils to push the speeds of their boats to unheard levels, while trying to avoid certain death. Families would come to this glorious resort and bask in the mineral-rich waters that proclaimed to soften and tighten the skin. But paradise would never last.
Today I'm declaring a drought emergency in the state of California because we're facing perhaps the worst drought that California has ever seen.
Before it was a sanctuary, but unlike its inception, the Salton Sea now receives 90% of its inflow from agricultural runoff from the Imperial, Coachella, and Mexicali valleys. The other major source for the Salton Sea is from the New River, which has the honor of being the most polluted river in America. The 11 initial species of fish have died off due to the increased salinity levels and lack of oxygen in the salty water, so only the tilapia is able to survive in the Salton Sea. To compound the issue, the inflows that replenish the sea are heavily laden with agricultural fertilizers that create algae blooms, which cause hypoxic conditions that kill off the majority of fish. Without the fish as a food source for over 400 different species of birds, many which are endangered, would almost ensure their inevitable demise. This product of man-made negligence, which has dire effects on countless species, is not half a world away, but has been created in our backyard. It's easy to turn a blind eye to a dead town, but what happens when this occurs where a blind eye cannot be turned? What are some things we can do to fight drought conditions locally so history does not repeat itself? One solution to our plummeting water levels lie in the hands of engineers, but it's not viable for these engineers to create more fresh water. Instead, they must innovate new systems that conserve water more efficiently. One of the ways to conserve water is addressing how it's transported. Evaporation from canals, dams, and aqueducts eliminate millions of acre-feet of water per year. Designing a series of underground aqueducts will protect the water meant for California in a powerful way. Collecting and preserving may benefit water shortage in the long run, but the most immediate and effective solution is to decrease water consumption, particularly in agriculture. California produces more than half of the nation's fruits and vegetables, and consumes nearly 80% of the water from state water projects. By implementing new irrigation methods, such as drip irrigation, would decrease the needless waste of water. The Salton Sea is an example of the delicate natural environment around Southern California that is highly dependent on the state's scarce water resources. It is our responsibility to protect our land, preserve scarce resources, and protect these natural environments that make California so unique.